My students are always surprised when I tell them that the word Taraweeh means to chill. You see, Taraweeh is not supposed to be this really long 2-hour sprint that a person just pushes themselves to get through. Taraweeh is supposed to be something a little different than that. To recognize what Taraweeh is supposed to be, we need to take a look at the book by the name of Al-Hadi al-Nabawi al-Sahih fi Salat al-Taraweeh by Sheikh Sabuni. Alhamdulillah, I had the opportunity to be a part of its translation, which was done by Saad Qasmi, and there's a translation right here. In order to see what Taraweeh is supposed to be, we need to look at the era of Umar radiallahu anhu. And I'm not talking about the 8 versus 20 debate. I honestly cannot care less about that. What I'm talking about is the philosophy of the prayer. You see, early Muslims, they gave a lot of value to worth. So, for example, if you look at the Qur'ans that were just published a few decades ago, and even today, a lot of them say that while you're reciting the Qur'an and you get tired, then put the Quran away and read it another time. The Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught us, "Al-anatu min Allah wal-ajalatu min ash-shaytan." Doing things calmly and slowly is from Allah, and rushing things is from shaytan. So when Umar radiallahu anhu kind of, you know, officialized the Taraweeh prayer, the way that it was done was a little bit different. And I'm not saying that the way we're doing it is bad. I understand why we do it. But I would just like to draw a picture for you on the way that it's supposed to be. So for those of us who are able to do something about their Taraweeh, if we're able to change the way we perform our Taraweeh, at least those of us can do it in that manner. When Umar radiallahu anhu established Taraweeh in Jama'ah in the mosques, the way that it was performed was that people would perform 20 rak'ahs. When they would perform 4 rak'ahs, they would take a break. They would chill. And that break would be just as long as the 4 rak'ahs prayer. So let's say they pray 4 rak'ahs in like 20 minutes, then they would take a 20 minutes break. And then 4 more, and then the break again. And 4 more, and the break again. So, yes, it took a long time. But the 4 rak'ahs that you would offer with the imam, you would be allowed to focus in those 4 rak'ahs. The people of Makkah, what they started doing is that in that break, they started offering tawaf of the Kaaba. So the people of Medina got jealous that, you know, they have the opportunity to perform tawaf. So in their breaks, they started offering nafil salah. Regardless, there used to be this time, this break in the middle, in which you could make dua, dhikr, have tea, whatever. And that, I feel, is really missing. I know why practically it's impossible, because it will take like 3 hours or 2.5 hours or 2 hours to perform the Taraweeh prayer. But I feel like at least some of us can do that. You know, people have the 10-day Taraweeh prayer, which goes on much later into the night. So if people are able to establish that, perhaps it is something that is not so far-fetched after all. What do you think? Do you think it is something that could help you? I know it would definitely help me. Just some food for thought. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.